Hello. Hey everybody, welcome back to my channel. This is Epi with Epi Reviews. I have mousse still in my hair, so ignore that. This is gonna be my review and recap of Legendary season. What season are we in? Season 3, season 4? It's the new season of Legendary. The first 3 episodes are out and we're gonna watch them today. I did all in honor of Legendary. I thought I would give you a little face, a little hair. Little Donna Summer situation and circumstance. I'm doing all of the things. I did all the things today. I did all the things to my face today. So. All right. So are we, if we're ready, I'm ready. I'm not going to fight with my lash all day. Let's get into it, shall we? I'm ready. Shout out to the live audience being back. Me and these lashes, Jesus. Shout out to the live audience because that brings a whole different element to this ballroom situation that was lacking last season with them doing it during COVID and they couldn't have a live audience. So, because the groups have something to feed off of when there's a live audience. So, I mean, yes. So the new judge is Keke Palmer, who's replacing baby girl Meg Thee Stallion, and she performed her song Bottoms Up. What the Kids Bop Disney ballroom song is this? Okay, I'm gonna let that baby have it. Amen. Listen, I done ran out of Red Bull. I don't even know. I can't. What? All right. Okay, so they just ran through the names of the house in the beginning of the, you know, with the song, wherever you want to be, legendary. I couldn't read all of the names because of the font that they put them in, some of them in. But some of the ones that I was able to read and stick out to me, House of Light, House of Alpha and Omega, House of Juicy Couture. House of Juicy Couture. House of Juicy Couture? All right. Okay. Okay, so because it's 10 houses, it's going to be two. I'm going to do episode 1 and 2 together, which is the Grand March. First 5 houses, they have to show, they have to do their routine. They have to show all 5 elements. Handwork, floor work, spins and dips, catwalk, duck walk. Okay, and then at the end of each episode, somebody's gonna be, a house will be sent home. So, let's get into it. Oh, but wait, there's more. I took that lash off because it was bothering me. I'm gonna put it back on. They have a gag flag for if they feel like a house has been done wrong, and they're scoring and such, like they're in trouble, maybe about to go home, they could pull out their gag flag and that house gets immunity for the evening. Each judge has one gag flag and they can only one gag flag can be used in a ball or an episode, and each judge only gets to do it one time the entire season. This gonna be okay. Justice for Tishi. This is because Tishi went home when they shouldn't have. This is the direct result of Tishi being sent home when they absolutely should not have been, and they should have won the whole season. Okay. This is a new season. I'm going to try. Let's go. Okay, first up on the runway, I swear I'm going to put the lash on in a second, is the House of LaBeija. The House of LaBeija is 60 years old. It is one of the first established houses of the ballroom. So, and this is their first appearance on this show. So, I'm excited. All right. I'll be back after they perform. And hopefully my lash will be on. So we just gonna throw Aja, LaBeija, Aja, 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 Aja from RuPaul's Drag Race and nobody, Richard's Drag Race at all. Nobody's gonna. Okay. Okay, so I'm gonna give you my lashes back on. I still don't like the placement, but we just gonna roll with it. Okay, so it didn't feel cohesive to me. This is just to me. This is Ebony's personal opinion. Doesn't mean that it's right or wrong or indifferent. It's just this is how I felt watching it. It felt like they weren't a cohesive unit. Like they were trying to be, but it's just like they weren't all gelled together. It could be the nervousness from it being a first performance, but that's how it came across in the presentation to me. Oh, Heffa, what you doing? Okay. I got absolutely the pain in my butt. That's how it came across to me, that it was kind of not sloppy, but not as tight and hit it. You know what I'm saying? That's how that came across to me. I would give them an 8. We're going to see what the judges say. Okay, so I wasn't crazy because the judges said the same thing that I did. It was a little sloppy. They got 7s and 8s from all of the judges. So, okay, let me make sure I'm not crazy and saying something out the way so I get cussed out. They said the same thing that I did, but okay. All right, so let's see who the next house is. The next house is the house of Alpha and Omega. I think I know people who are in the house. So keep my eye on them. Yes, Alpha and Omega. Yes. Come listen. They were over. Do you hear me? I enjoyed that a whole lot. I'm going to give them a 9. It didn't dawn on me. Oh, there are no women in their crew. Until they hit the floor. I don't know why it didn't dawn on me. But it still didn't matter. It didn't matter. Yes, honeys. Gave me all 5 elements. Let's see what the judges have to say. Okay, so the judges, again, we're on the same line. Most of them get a 9. They got a 10 from Jamila. Well, of course, because Jamila is the one who's, if somebody's going to give a 10, it's going to be her. But yeah, it was really good. It was really good. It's really good. All right, so let's see who's next. The next house is the house of Revlon. Revlon? Revlon. Like the makeup. Revlon. Yes. Yes. The house of Revlon is from France. First international house, maybe? I don't know. I don't remember. I'm not sure if that's true. Don't quote me on that. But they're going to give you looks and fashion. And their Grand March routine is based on Jean-Paul Gaultier. They have like the little the French mime outfit with the white striped shirt and the red and the beret. We gonna see what. Okay, all right, I'm here for it. Okay, that was very ooh la la. They didn't give all five elements either. It was really good. It was really cute. I enjoyed it. I'm gonna switch lashes. This is driving me crazy. I enjoyed it a lot. I'm going to give them a 9. I feel like they possibly might get a 10 because the ending where they flipped baby over his shoulders and he was in a squat and he had the crown cut, giving them all of the face like, bitch, try me. Whew, that made me touch my little heart. Oh, I liked it. La being real cute on this first episode. Where the real Law at? I'm waiting for him to get comfortable and start cutting bitches' throats. Because this cutesy stuff, I don't know. I don't know if I like that. I don't know if I like that at all. But the judges gave them all 8s and 9s. So once again, me and the judges are on the same wavelength. Let's get into the next house. I'm still with these lashes, y'all. Listen, I'm gonna figure it out. The next house is the house of Machiavelli. Machiavelli? I didn't know Tupac had a house, but okay, I'm here for it. Listen. That's when you say Machiavelli, that's what I get. I get, I'm very much fuck the bitch and the click you claim. What's that? Okay, I'm sure that it's not. Just let me have it. So you're trying to make me cry before, so these lashes don't really want to stick on my face? That's rude and disrespectful. They are talking about, first of all, the only one in the interview is the mother of the house because the four boys got tested positive for COVID. Merciful God. They still on the Zoom and the FaceTime so they can do whatever they need to do and so they're clear to perform. Secondly, she's talking about she's been the mother of the house since her house dad passed away, the legendary Boogie Machiavelli, and she's giving him his flowers, which is absolutely beautiful, but it's making me a little emotional, and I'm trying to put on these lashes, and that's not helpful. But we're going to see how it goes. I don't know how I feel about Machiavelli. I wasn't as excited. Like, they didn't hold my attention. I'm going to give them an 8. Like, they literally just finished, and I don't remember anything about their routine. That's not a good thing. It's not a good thing at all. This house is really trying to make me cry once I got my damn lashes on. So the judges were a lot less generous than I was. They gave them all 5s and 6s. The one baby was like really upset. He was like, I was really nervous and I came out and I tried to put my best foot forward and he apologized for not giving his best. And you know, his mama tried to prop him up and so did the judges try and get him to understand this is just the beginning. This is just one thing, you know, please don't beat yourself up. This is just, don't take it all on like it's all your fault. Y'all came in with a deficit being that everyone had COVID. So I don't know if group practices were, y'all were able to do that to begin with. So it, we understand, but y'all got the scores that y'all got. Hopefully y'all can go into the bottom challenge with whoever is at the bottom with y'all and pull it out so that you can come back again. Whew, God, made me nervous, Jesus. Okay, made me want to cry. All right, here we go. Next up is that... It's the House of Light. They were founded in 2020. So, super young house. We're going to see what happens. Y'all can literally see my ADHD and OCD kicking in because this lash is... Okay. So, the House of Light is a house of professional dancers. If I don't see somebody spinning like a whirling dervish, I'm going to be angry. I'm already angry at my lashes. Because this one is on a gangsta lean for no reason. And I just... Oh, Earth is ghetto. I want to leave. Earth is ghetto. Okay. All right, let's get back to this house. I don't think that gave the way that they thought it was going to give. I honestly don't think that gave the way they thought it was going to give. I'm going to give it an 8. They had all the elements. It was missing, like the soul of it was missing. Like, it was sanitized. It wasn't gritty and grimy like I needed it to be. You know what I'm saying? It didn't give like I need. We're going to see what the judges say. Maybe I'm tripping. But I feel like it was missing, it's too, not too clean, but it just was missing, like the heart of it was missing or something. I don't know, something was, Okay, so I wasn't wrong. Listen, when Naomi gave her score, she says, okay, so Deshaun says, you know what, when you see it, did you see it tonight? She was like, no, I didn't like it. She said, it gave me, we created a word in ballroom called noguing, which is like a mockery. Like, you don't know what, you think you know what voguing is. So you do just a little thinking that you're voguing and you're eating and you have left the entire plate full. You ate nothing. You made a mockery of what this is. And this is the difference between Tishi and this group here. Tishi had professional dancers, but they were all ingrained in the ballroom. So they knew what it was. They knew what it felt like. It felt authentic when they added their professional dancing into the voguing and all the other things that they were doing. This feels the exact opposite. They have no ballroom experience. They don't know what it exactly is. They have an idea of what it should look like. And so they, through their professional skills, added, and it has no weight to it. Laomi gave them a 3. I was being nice because it's the first episode and everybody's first. She gave them a 3, y'all. I ain't even got to the rest of the judges. She gave them a 3. 1, 2, 3. She gave them a 3. Okay. All right. I'm just gonna. Okay. So Law was like, I don't even know how to feel about it. He gave them a 6. Jamila tried to give him a pep talk. She gave him a 5. Baby girl Kiki gave him a 5. That's 10, 16, 19. They got a 19. I believe that's the lowest score ever on this show. They are saying this is the worst thing that they've ever seen in 3 seasons. This is the worst routine they've seen in 3 seasons. And we've talked about some routines that were not great on this show, but they said this is the worst thing. And what is killing me is that the fact that the one boy on this group had something negative to say about every single house when they performed. He had something catty, nasty, and snotty to say. And then they got up there and laid that big old egg. And now y'all in the bottom are going to have to fight for your lot. Merciful Jesus. So the House of Alpha Omega won the week. LaBeija and Revlon are safe, and it comes down to the bottom to the House of Light and, oh God. And the House of Machiavelli. I knew I would get, y'all know I'm old. Don't do that. Don't do that. All right. So it's going to be Mara Machiavelli versus the House Father of Light. And he said, I'm standing before you sober. Don't try to get sympathy for points. But it's my last name and we're going to defend. I'm going to defend it. So the House Father from Light versus Mara Machiavelli. Jamila said, you've been in the house ballroom since 2005. We better see ballroom on the stage. I said, ooh. Well, all right. Okay. Well, Jesus Christ. I'm with Jamila. All right, let's see what happens. That was the most lackluster battle. Y'all fighting for your life to stay in a competition for $100,000. I feel like Miss Mara said, let me handle this light work because this nigga don't know what he really talking about. He don't know what he really doing, so I ain't gonna really do too much. I ain't gotta really do too much to get this nigga on out of here. This dancing man, I don't even know what that dance is called. I don't even know what it's called. But I know it was inappropriate here. Go home. It has been lovely. House of Light, I appreciate you. They could send both of them home at this juncture because it was just lackluster. Like, I feel like neither one of them was really gave a damn. Maybe I'm tripping. Let's see what the judges. Maybe I'm by myself and how I feel. Maybe it's because my lashes is aggravating my nerves. I don't know. We'll see. I'm about to have no lashes on for the rest of this. I was right. Machiavelli won because they actually vote. She actually... Pussy cunt. Okay. Ooh, am I not... I'm saying it. Baby girl did what needed to be done according to the instructions that they were given. So she won. Point blank period, the end. The boy did the shoot dance. Jesus Christ. Why would you do that in a... Like, I don't even understand how your mindset even got there. I would have spun until Jesus came back, but that's just me. What do I know? I would have spun and dipped my way and duck walked or something. I don't even know how to duck. My knees is not going to allow me to duck walk, but I would have done something, baby. Wooey. Okay. That was the first episode of Legendary Season 3. I'm going to break it up. I'm going to do three different things. So I'm going to move right on to, and I still have this wonky lash in, or no lash at all. I might take the lashes. Listen, the lashes are just distracting me and vexing my spirit, man. But, and I don't want to be talking in all three episodes about the, you know what? I can't. Y'all can't even tell. like, comment, and subscribe. Tell a friend, tell a kid. I'll catch y'all in the next one. Peace.